Ato, nare-repair pa. Wala nang ilis eh, oh. Wala nang engine, oh. Ang kabila, mayroon. Ano, pakilo na lang to, no? Ha? Oo. Ano lang to eh. Eh, mahal ang ano niyan. Mahal yung aluminum. Platinum pa niyan. Platinum diyan eh. Yung mga junk na aeroplano rito. No? Nakatarga ngayon ano itong aeroplano ng DHL dito sa rampa ng Nino Aquino International Airport. Napakaraming kargamento. Ay, malalaki na yan. Diyan na isa sa kaya. Napakarami pa ikakarga na ito. Yan lahat. Nakikita nyo yan. Oh, na. Napakarami pa yan. Oh. Malalaki. Malalaking iakyat dito sa aeroplano ng DHL.
coming out so early this morning to witness our launch of our new Airbus A330 Air Hong Kong VHL Express aircraft. This aircraft gives us 31% more capacity into the Philippines and also earlier deliveries for our customers in the Philippines. And that further attests our investment here in the Philippines, and we'll continue to invest to improve our services for our customers here in this great country. So without further ado, let me introduce you to your tour guide for today, Mr. Jocas Castellano, who is our Gateway Operations Manager, and Alan Del Rosario, who is our Network Control Manager. So Alan and Jocas will just guide you through the aircraft and what we do here out on the tarmac each and every day. So thank you very much, and again, thank you for joining us.
AT30 -300. So before we are using the AT100 aircraft, which only has the 42 tons, and now we are having the capacity of 55 tons. This aircraft has two compartment configurations, so it has the main deck compartment and the lower deck compartment. The main deck compartment is composed of 26 positions. So those are the bigger ULDs or containers. The lower deck compartment is now can accommodate 32 positions compared from the previous of 22 positions.
Yep, good morning. This aircraft is flying Hong Kong, Manila and Cebu 6 times a week. Under rotation, it would be 12 days. Hong Kong, Manila, Cebu, day over in Cebu, and would fly back to Manila in the evening and go back to Hong Kong.
Sorry. Okay, so for this time, we will ask taking questions from the media, and you will be joined by, of course, Sir Nigel, Sir Promod George, the operations head, and of course, Sir Eric Kitten for commercial head. So, for our media, if you have any questions.
How many aircraft we have?
Aircraft coming into the Philippines, as Jocas mentioned, we have the one aircraft. It leaves Hong Kong early in the morning, arrives here in Manila in the morning, offloads and then goes down to Cebu, lays over all day in Cebu, and then from Cebu in the evening, Manila and then Hong Kong. So just the one aircraft.
How much do you
spend for it's a partnership that we have with Cathay. Joint venture to the aircraft. It's called Air Hong Kong. So it's a partnership with the Japanese. So VHL and Cathay have that partnership where we have a 15-year agreement and that's where the aircraft comes from.
When is that agreement?
2033 is when it ends. But it's going to be extended out.
With the easing of all restrictions, how is the business right now for Asia?
We're seeing the GDP growth of the Philippines will be very positive, as forecasted by different agencies, including IMF and World Bank. And we're banking on that bullish forecast to ride on those growth of the Philippines, particularly the domestic market. And also coming from our tech sector and automotive sector. So we are very positive on the forecast that the government is making for the GDP.
And are we experiencing delays for the supply chain or supply chain disruption right now?
I think everything is back to normal now, the COVID pandemic. So pretty much almost 100% everything is back to normal.
Sir, do you have any intention to print the aircraft?
The question is, do we have intentions to add more aircraft? But that's always something that we look at, depending on demand, depending on capacity, depending on the routes that we fly for. So a few months ago, you would have heard an announcement that DHL is partnering with Singapore Airlines
We have the partnership with Cathay Pacific, which is this airline. So we continuously look at our weights, our loads, to see whether we need to add more aircraft. In the COVID period, we had added more aircraft coming in because of the demand. And again, throughout the year, we look at different sectors, whether the demand is there to add more aircraft.
Hello sir, good morning. What are the issues on shipping delays and higher consumer prices? How will you respond to that? What are your plans to hedge your costs? Thank you.
So in terms of hedging, this is a question of hedging our costs. Okay, so you know, we have what we call you know, cost containment measures that we do throughout the year. We look at making sure that we are efficient. If we talk in terms of the aircraft specifically, we make sure that these are all fuel efficient aircraft, the newer ones, so we save a bit of money on fuel for the aircraft. And on the ground as well, we make sure that, you know, all our processes are efficient. We make sure that they are as lean as possible all across the network, so that we can manage our costs and cut out any waste.
Hello, good morning. I understand that fuel prices were high in 2022. So, and right now, well, it has kind of also a bit, and it's still remaining high. How are your keeping costs low for that matter?
We're using a dynamic fuel surcharge when it comes to managing our fuel surcharges. No? What's good about this is we will be changing this depending on how the market is actually evolving. So that is also good for our customers, very transparent to our customers. When we are implementing this fuel surcharge, it as far as our customers will use.
Hi, can you share the portfolio of your deliveries? Which sector is driving the, which sector has the most share of the deliveries, and which sector is have the highest?
Sorry,
the portfolio of your deliveries, which sector shares the most?
Deliveries?
Yeah.
Okay. E-commerce continues to be our sources of growth.
So. Like what percent of the total?
I cannot give you right now the numbers, but what we are seeing is this is a continuous sector that is actually spurring growth for our business, and including the deliveries, because these are individuals that are ordering online and that direct delivery to their different homes and offices. So, and we are continuing to expect growth from this sector even after the pandemic and the economic is opening up.
Is that the main driver for your expansion?
This is one of the major drivers right now. Of course, on top of other sectors like tech, industry, automotive, retail sectors, and more especially on the retail market. These are the individual OFW that are sending their relatives abroad. So these are also the major drivers for our business.
Any plans also to add a destination apart from Manila, Hong Kong?
So right now the aircraft flies from Hong Kong to Manila and then goes on to Cebu as well. So Cebu is something that we added in 2019. So as of now, these are the two stations in Manila that we are operating to. In the future, when the volume grows, you know, we are open to the idea of adding other sectors. For now, it's Manila and Cebu.
In terms of delivery costs, what do you expect your rates to increase this year, given the expectations that fuel prices of jet fuel will keep on going up?
Every year we are implementing a price increase every January of this year. This is based on the inflation of the market and also other costs that we are seeing right now. So this is an annual exercise that we're doing across all our customers, that to also drive also to cover the cost that we have also expected that is impacting our business.
Are you also implementing the monthly fuel surcharge by the CED, the monthly fuel surcharge?
We've been implementing fuel surcharge separately from the freight cost. Ever since the CAB has implemented this in the Philippines. So we've been very consistent and very transparent.
Senior management team. Thank you.
So, tapos na ang question and answer ng mga official ng DHL dito sa tarmac ng Ninoy Aquino International Airport.
Tapos maliban dun sa mga pinipisita ang bahay na. Walang labi, walang ulan. Servisyong totoo.